Hey, good afternoon, and welcome back to Answers on Eschatology. My name is Dan Derry, and I'm the president of the Institute of Fulfilled Eschatology. Hey, before we get into this, my prayers are with all of you, all of your families. I pray that the Lord keeps you in health, and during this coronavirus epidemic, stay healthy, wash your hands, and stay self-isolated as much as you can during this crazy time. So I pray that the peace of God, the health of God be with you all. And let's jump into Revelation study lesson number 2. This afternoon, I don't really want to get into any specific verse, but I want to give for you some studies that I've done a while back. It's a 4-part series entitled Word Studies on Time Statements. And what I do and what I'm going to upload to this video is a 4-part series that where we look at 3 specific Greek words used in the book of Revelation to refer to the near, soon, or quickly coming of Jesus Christ in that first century generation. So here's what I do. I look at these 3 Greek words. The first one is tekos. It's used 7 times in the New Testament, including in the book of Revelation. The second Greek word is taki. That is used 13 times throughout the New Testament, including the book of Revelation. And the last Greek word is agis, used 30 times throughout the New Testament, including the book of Revelation. And throughout these studies, and by the way, we'll get into more of this in an upcoming video, probably when we get to verse 7, but there is a powerful inclusio, a parallel, between verses chapter 1, verses 1 through 3, and chapter 22 in the book of Revelation, 6 through 12, and then including verse 20. And these Greek words are used in all of those passages, chapter 1 and chapter 22. And it forms a powerful parallel, but also an inclusio, which limits the entire prophecy to the first century generation. So here's what I do with these word studies. And I encourage you, I will attach each part, 4 parts, to this video. Go through them. There's several page studies each, but it's good stuff. I systematically go through every single reference. There's about 50 references here throughout the New Testament, including the book of Revelation, where I show 3 things. Number 1, I show that all 3 of these Greek words in every single non-eschatological text refer to either time, people, places, or events that were in fact near or soon to take place or quickly to come about within that first century generation. And everybody, non-preterists included, would agree with this assessment. In the non-eschatological texts, everyone's on the same page. Soon means soon, quickly means quickly, shortly means shortly, near means it's close to the time when it's gonna take place, okay? That's a given. What I do next in these studies is show that all 3 of those Greek words, based on their context, near, quickly, shortly, etc., they are all limited to the first century generation. In other words, shortly, soon, quickly does not extend beyond a 40-year time frame. That's important. Soon, quickly, shortly is limited to one generation in all of the time statements using these Greek words in the New Testament. And what that means is my 3rd point, I prove powerful in these studies that in the book of Revelation, in both the non-eschatological and the eschatological text, which the latter is the primary usage in the book of Revelation, all 3 of these Greek words, if we're consistent with language, they must mean the same thing as the non-eschatological text in the New Testament, but based on the context in the book of Revelation, all 3 Greek words are also limited to the first century generation, either explicitly or by using the analogy of faith, comparing scripture with scripture implicitly. Every single Greek word, taki, takos, and agis, outside of the book of Revelation, in the book of Revelation, non-eschatological and eschatological passages refer to people, places, time, or events that are limited to the first century generation. And what that powerfully demonstrates through these studies is that in Revelation 1:1 through 3 and Revelation 22, 6 through 12 and verse 20, soon, at hand, quickly, means that these events and the prophecy, the coming of the Lord that this book predicts must have taken place within that first century generation, just like the book demands, just like the language demands, and just like every other passage outside of the book demands. That's powerful stuff. Guys, take the time, go through the studies that I will upload. See for yourself, check them out verse by verse, passage by passage, systematically look at it for yourself. And you can say to people, yeah, hey, look, when we get to the book of Revelation, soon, shortly, quickly, near, at hand, all of these time statements mean exactly what they mean outside of the book of Revelation. The eschatological texts mean the same as they do in non-eschatological texts. And that's a powerful demonstration. It's a powerful proof to our Christian brothers who want to place this book in our future that we must limit the prophecy of the book of Revelation to the coming of the Lord at the fall of Jerusalem at the end of the Jewish age in AD 70, just like John predicted, just like Jesus predicted, just like the rest of the apostles predicted. And that's it, guys. Go into this video, click on these links, check this stuff out for yourself, be amazed. And we'll see you next time on Answers on Eschatology. We'll jump into probably verse 4 of Revelation chapter 1. And we'll see you next time on Answers on Eschatology. Have a great week. Stay safe, stay healthy, and may the peace and the blessing of God go with you all. See you soon. Bye for now.